cheeky answer to someone like that, so they won't say that again to you.
As long
just
as you're
happy with the way you look. Or I get people who say, I'm fine, but I just want to lose weight on my face. When I take pictures, my face looks very chubby. So I send them to my friend who's a makeup artist, and I say, learn how to contour.
Alright, the girls in the back had a question.
What's with the no carbs after sunset? Like, how do you live like that? How do you live without carbs after sunset? Wow.
So, everyone does not need to not eat carbs after sunset. But if you're training in the evening, if you're working out in the evening, then definitely push in some carbs in the evening. But not for everyone, you know. What is it that you're looking for?
The thing is, if I have a light meal, like it's not carbohydrate, like then the morning...
You understand fruits and vegetables have carbohydrates as well.
Yeah, exactly.
You know that.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's
okay.
The only thing I end up having. Like fruits and vegetables at night. Then I drop weight in the morning and...
But you're still having your carb because you are
exactly
eating.
Exactly. So you can't have roti, sabzi like later on the...
But you cannot eat fruit and vegetable for dinner. You cannot do that.
Like
you will not lose weight.
Yeah, that's the thing. I'm not losing weight with that.
But you just said you wake up in the morning and your scale is...
Yeah, it's
so
a little
one
bit.
First thing is you throw your scale.
Scale.
Okay,
exactly.
Throw
that's
the damn scale.
Yes.
Second thing is when you're eating, if you're eating to lose weight, alright, you've got to be smart with your macros. When I say macros means your carb, protein, fat. These are your macros. What you've done is only eaten carbs at night. So forget about weight loss. I don't know your body completely, but what I would recommend generically is you do protein and fat at night. So you're better off having, I don't know, eggs with avocado or let's say dal with sabzi. That also has carbs, but at least there's protein and fat in it as well. Or chicken and veggies, I don't know, depending. Are you vegetarian?
No, I said chicken.
You had chicken, yeah? So chicken and vegetables is perfect. That's way better than having just fruit and salad, yeah.
You had a question, yeah.
Every day we are bombarded with different kinds of fitness regime, diets and everything. So what to follow and what to not? Like you are telling a completely different thing as per the diet.
Right.
And when we go through internet or the television and when we go through newspapers, every day there's a new funda for diet, fitness and workouts, different kinds of workouts.
See,
so
it is very, very confusing. I agree. There are some people who say go by calories, some people say no, some people say cut your portions out. I think it's what's important is you understand your body, you know. Like again, first fix a goal. What is your goal? You have to fix a goal, alright, that this is how much I want to lose and please not weight. It's got to be body fat percent, alright, that's one. Now if you have, for example, you go get your body fat percentage done and your muscle is very low, for most Indian women, okay, most of you, if you do your analysis, your muscle mass is going to be low, that's for sure. I don't know how you have 27 kgs of muscle on you. Obviously how means you've obviously been training for so long, which is
now
why.
It's become 26
one of
with my knee broken.
Oh, sure. It's okay, you'll build it back up. Yeah, but if you're low on muscle, but high on fat, which is pretty much a lot of us here, then you have to increase your protein. So you'll have to eat more dal, more chicken, more, you know, fish, more eggs, more all of that. So you have to understand your body. Not everyone is going to be successful on a gluten-free plan. When you eat wheat, does it bloat you? Do you feel tired? Do you feel edgy? If you do, then cut it out for a week and see what you feel like. So understand about it, tune into it, you know.
Also, I know you're fancy, it's confusing, but you know what? I think the best way to judge it is which one can you adopt permanently?
Yeah, and stick to it.
You know, like look at, there's so many things on the internet. If you look at it and you say, you know what, this is not something that I can make my lifestyle, then clearly that diet is not for you. Because what you have to do is you have to follow a food plan that becomes your lifestyle so that you're doing it every day. Yes, when you want to lose a bit of extra weight, you have to push yourself a little bit further, but by and large, you have to eat what you can eat consistently every day. So if you're looking at things and you're just saying, there's no possible way I can do that, then that diet's not for you.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what, the first time I ate sweet potato and avocado, I was like,
say limit yourself to this many calories in a day. If you cannot function doing that, you don't understand how to do that, that diet is not for you.
Exactly.
Or if there's something that tells you, only do protein and nothing else.
Exactly.
That's just not feasible. You have to, you know, follow something that's sensible. That's, I think that's the best advice to give.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? That's extreme. Do a diet of barley water or do a diet of, you know, pineapple
that's
juice. That's so ridiculous. Yeah. None of that is ever going to work. You have to be sensible enough to look at a diet and say, this balances things out in a way that I can deal with,
yeah.
I think. And that's right.
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
I think the most important thing is not to Google so much on the internet. Okay, because internet is not Indian bodies only. And every country has a different set of food and a different set of body types and things like that. So it's much better to follow someone in your vicinity, in your area. Again, in India, there are so many states and every state has different kinds of food. So what, you know, like a diet that we follow in Bombay might not be a diet you follow in Indore or in Chandigarh. You know, the food available is different. So internet is great for a lot of things, but for something as personal as food and exercise, it's very individualistic and your body is your own. It's no one else's. What works for me will not work for you. You know, if I have 27 kgs of fat, muscle, she can't have that even if she starts lifting heavy weights because her body is made up differently. So understand your own body first, okay? Sophie said, find a diet that works for you. Don't find a diet that has everything that you like to eat, which might not be good for you. So be sensible, be smart. All of us have smartphones. I keep coming back to the smartphones, but it's a great example because everyone goes around saying, I'm so smart, or, you know, or in your mind, you're thinking you're smarter than the next person, you know, the person next to you. Then why the hell are you not making, sorry for the language, smart choices in life? If you're smart, make smart workout and food choices for a smarter, healthier, better life.
Any more questions?
Yeah. Some recipe that you could carry, a quick bite that you could carry to work and keep the energy going on.
Well, firstly, if you log on to our website, you'll find a million recipes every day, new recipes coming up every day. But the best thing to do is have fun with your food, like I said before, and be prepared so you can make like hummus or avocado butter and keep it in your fridge stocked up. So if you just cut out a few vegetables, throw a dollop of that, carry a little bit of your brown rice. Every day you have a different lunchbox idea. You can whip up salads and, you know, things that make it interesting, and choose your vegetables with color. Everything that has color is really, really good for you. You know, the darker the colors, the better it is. So you fill up your box with colorful veggies and you look at it and it looks so good when you open it in your lunch break and, you know, you had a horrible boss and he's yelling at you and you suddenly open up the box like, oh my god, like I have this yummy meal to go to. So you keep yourself prepared like that. And another thing that she said is about movement. When you're talking on the phone, you're moving around. You do it on the weekend. You go to a farmer's market, you look at these amazing vegetables, you move your body to find your food on the weekend. So the whole week is prepared for. Have your stuff ready, you know, stacked up. You know what you're gonna cook. And you're gonna have fun with your entire, you know, health regime. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Is avocado fruit or vegetable?
Fruit. Oh, sorry. It's both.
Is the butter good?
Of course, the avocado butter is the most delicious thing you can ever have.
Yeah. So has it got a lot of fat?
Like I'm going to say this to you, I'm sure she... Listen, so avocados is one thing you have to include if you're struggling with stubborn weight or you have PCOD, any of those things. Because like I said, that's the kind of fat that makes the hormones inside your body. You want to be hormonally healthy all the time. Yeah, so you have to add avocado or butter or, I don't know, nut butters.
I'm going to... She knows this better probably, but... A Mars bar, a chocolate Mars bar, has the exact same amount of calories that you would find in an avocado, okay? But what you're eating in that avocado, it's like having the ghee or the coconut oil in the morning. You're giving your body the best that you can. You're going to glow, you're going to look good, you're going to lose that fat because you're eating that right thing. You're not eating that chocolate bar that's going to give you pimples and you're going to look horrible and you're going to put on weight. But with this avocado, you're going to lose weight, you're going to eat the right stuff, and yet you're eating the exact amount of calories that your dietitian is telling you to eat. So you're just right on track if you eat an avocado.
So it's a good substitute for butter.
It is, absolutely. It's a good substitute.
What about white rice?
Okay, white rice depends a lot on your digestive tract. So a lot of my clients who don't respond well to wheat, we do white rice. White rice actually is very alkaline. So if you're someone who's struggling with any inflammatory disorders, you must include white rice over gluten products. So like, get your chapati out, get your bread out, and replace it with white rice. Even my diabetic clients, I'll give them white rice, but then I'll make them put a tablespoon of ghee on it.